pet it. Pet it. Minutes of Stacey just petting the robot dog.
Look at him, he's so cute. Aww.
And that's it, that's the whole let's play. Just Stacey petting the dog.
You shouldn't have told me there was a robot dog. We're never gonna get anything else done.
If you go into the thing in front of you, you can play fetch with it.
Where?
Left. No, just... Oh my god! Oh my god!
You said I could play fetch. I don't understand how that was playing fetch.
My god, Stacey! In front of you, just go there! Alright, why? How do you have the ball? How do you have that? Just play with it. Who cares?
How did this get here?
I don't know. I don't know how you got that.
I'm also standing in rocks right now.
Yeah, so you can move around a bit. So now you're inside of a cage with balloons. What? I don't remember getting this. Why do you have balloons in here?
I have no clue.
How did you get that? You're not supposed to have that.
I didn't take it. I don't know how.
You're ballooning this cave.
I know. Okay, so.
Okay, so by the way, this is not Stacey's first VR game. This is like, we've been playing VR for like 10 hours. And she's like, what? What do we do?
Well, it's like, I don't know. I don't understand.
Okay, well, get out of here. Press the thingy. The top button.
Oh.
Or you can transport over there if you want and look at all like the different stuff. But it looks pretty cool, right? Like you're inside of a cave.
Yeah.
Okay, press the top button to get out. And yeah, put that bubble on your face.
Yeah, Stacey, why wouldn't you put the bubble on your face? I don't know, it's so easy to understand. Obviously, that's what you would do.
Put bubbles on your face?
Like,
I want you to go over to that tree. Don't go, you can't handle that. Go over to that tree. Go over to the tree.
Okay.
No, you have to transport it, you're in my face.
Okay.
You're having such a hard time.
Well, each thing is like slightly different, you know.
Put the bubble on your face.
On how to transport. So do you want me to put the bubble on my face?
Yes.
You told me I could play fetch with a dog.
Well, you clearly couldn't handle it. Somehow you got a balloon gun. So you can't play fetch with the dog anymore. Because I don't know why you did it. You ended up with a balloon gun. So I don't know how or how. Look at that thing. You can get real close to it, walk up to it, crouch down. So to me, it looks like a flat image, but to you, it looks like...
Ah,
turn around.
There you are. And look at you, standing alone in the dark. Why? I am a terrible host. Here, take my light. I know my way around well enough without it. Don't be afraid. There is plenty to see.
You're being rude to him, Stacey.
You're being rude.
Don't be surprised.
He told me to look around.
Okay, do whatever you want.
May hide in even the darkest corners. I was just closing up. But don't let that concern you. When it's time for lights out, well, you'll see. Well, I have a few deliveries.
Oh.
air now. Good thing Roclair is out for the night. Maybe I do need a light in here.
Oh, we got Thor's hammer up there.
Farewell, my friend.
You see it?
Yep. Look to your right. Look down. Okay, at the table.
Ah!
Well, you can also look at that thing. You thought that was going to get you, didn't you?
It did.
Look at the table.
Hey.
This table or that table?
Left.
This
see
one?
That rune?
Yeah.
Get it.
Oh my gosh.
Remember, Cece, you can walk around. You don't have to stand in one spot.
Oh my god, look, there he is. There's the little guy. Oh, and I can transport myself, right?
Just right click again. Wait, what do you do?
I was gonna try and transport myself somewhere, but I can't.
Oh, not here, you can't.
Okay.
You see those other ruins? You can go there too.
What other ruins?
You'll see. Just explore the area. Explore and try and find them.
This guy's funny.
You're just happy with the little lizard thing, aren't you? You just want to play with pets.
That's all I really want this for.
It looks like that's in your face, doesn't it?
It's like the book from Harry Potter. The book that tries. Remember the book of monsters that tries to eat everybody?
I thought it was the Necronomicon.
That could be that too. Another book that tries to eat everybody. Whoa.
Now you have to get big again before you can go to another one.
I wasn't gonna, like, jump.
Well, no, Stacey, I don't think you can jump. Because there's... Ah! Don't jump, Stacey! Don't jump!
Oh my god!
Look at that guy!
Hello! What's that? Oh my god, it's so cute.
Uh-oh.
What?
You're out of time, Stacey.
I am.
Look up.
Lab 8 has successfully survived an experiment.
Okay, so go turn to your right. Turn to your right. Turn to your right.
But the robot dog's over there.
I know. Turn to your left. To the table. On the table, there will be a stick. Grab that bone.
Right there?
Yeah, you can go over there. Turn around. Now you can play fetch with the dog.
Hey, puppy!
Experiment this or final.
Oh, Stacey wants. She just wants.
has just been discovered in Pocket Universe Lab 8. Congratulations, test traveler.
You have a new best friend.
Whoa. Oh, no!
How's he gonna get it now, Stacy? Come on!
Experiment Doppler Helo is missing.
That bone goes really good. Very floaty bone physics.
Stacy, is this gonna be the whole let's play?
I'm
just
sorry.
You
we'll
playing
go,
with the
we'll
dog.
Go somewhere else, okay? Whoop. Okay. Alright, where do we want to go?
Do you want to switch?
Here?
Do you want. Oh, yeah, go in there! Go in there! Go in there!
Successfully tested in pocket.
You're gonna love this.
I kinda like how you just, like, put your face in the bubble. It's so funny. Trying to explain things.
I know, it's hard to explain. No, put your face in the bubble. What?
I was like, well, what?
Wow. You can walk around, Stacy. Don't forget.
So we've got Saturn over.
Pick it up, pick it up.
Pick it up?
Yeah, throw it. Fuck the solar system.
Fuck this. Fuck you.
Went to Jupiter to get more stupider.
Fuck you. I wish they could explode. Okay.
Get Earth, get Earth. Get Earth.
Where?
Right there, right there.
Oh.
Grab it.
Oh.
Grab it.
Nope, it's not Mercury.
It's fuck Mercury.
There you go.
There,
oh, there we
got
go.
It. I always put all the planets back nice. You're like, fuck this planet.
Fuck it. We're going in the sun.
You know what's not here?
What?
Pluto.
How dare they? Hey, Mari.
What?
I've got Uranus.
Oh, Stacy.
Neptune.
Stacy just wants to throw everything. She's Gunter from Adventure Time. She just wants to break everything.
Yep, so it looks like all the planets are now out of place.
No, 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 wait. That one right there, get it.
No,
oh,
the,
no, it's okay.
It's already gone. Don't worry. Don't worry.
Don't worry, everything's fully fucked up.
Everything's fully fucked at this point. Okay. Got rid of the entire universe, right?
Well, the solar system. Don't oversell yourself.
Yeah, sorry.
You're just a god over this.
I'll have to think bigger next time. You're right. Why am I stopping at the universe?
Well, no, you're at the solar system right now.
I know. That's
you have to go. You have to go up from there.
Yeah, I know. That's what I said.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay. So
you can leave now.
Yeah, to go back. How do I?
Top button. And simply put your face into the bubble.
You know what? This would be a really cool way to teach subjects. Like, can you imagine teaching kids about, like, the...
Can you imagine giving kids $800
successful
equipment?
Completion of experiment
what
in
what I'm saying,
first lab 8.
At a certain point, you know, like, there are already places where they give laptops in schools. Like, not very... Like, you could have, like, these, like, in your school and be like, hey, this is, like, the...
Is now available.
Get in there.
Like, this is, look, human body. Like, and you could learn about the scale of the universe by popping one of these on and being like, wow, look at, you know, because with that, it's like, look how big the sun is compared to the earth, you know? You don't really think about that.
I know, yeah.
Until
they
you're
did
standing
really good.
Next to it.
Yeah, so simply stand next to the sun and you'll understand.
Yes. Ooh.
Now, drag, no, don't touch it. Grab that square. Grab the square. Now, move it.
Ooh. This is... Oh my gosh, did you ever go see those things in museums where they take bodies and they slice them into a million pieces so that
yeah.
you can walk between them?
Yeah.
Those are really cool. Like, they had, like, a whole horse that was, like, sliced into, like, inch pieces. Not inch, but you know what I mean?
No, that was from The Cell.
What?
That was from the movie The Cell.
No, they had. I've been to an exhibit like that.
I think I've been there too. I thought you were confusing the exhibit with the movie, The Cell.
Oh, I mean, I know that because I know they had them where you could like look in human lungs that were smokers' lungs and stuff like that.
And they were like all sliced up.
And they're like they're like horrible. All right, so what's this? Oh, and now we
pick the skull or something. Everybody always tries to look at the peep. So does this human being look huge?
Yeah. This human being looks, its head looks like it's the size of my torso. I mean, when it blows up, you know? I want to do the top part of the head.
Stick your head in it. Stick your head in it.
Whoa. Can you guys see it?
They can see it.
Okay. I'm hoping it's grossing some people out.
Ew! Gross! Nasty!
Okay,
get out of here.
Introducing the lab. I mean, see, you have an actual dog, so I'm sure playing fetch with a robot dog isn't quite as fun, but...
Against you always talk about how you don't want a dog.
Traveler of Pocket Universe Lab 8 has survived.
My one issue with having a dog is that I am kind of weird about dog hair.
Like, get a dog with hair.
What?
Get a dog with hair.
With no hair?
With hair.
Why with hair?
Never mind, just go for it. Get a dog with hair, like growing hair, not fur.
Oh, right. Yeah, I think I was traumatized from having so many dogs when I was growing up.
Hello, Repair Associate, and welcome to the Robot Rehabilitation and Wellness Center. Our records indicate that you are the inaugural participant in our Human Diversity Outreach Program. You are holding dual Aperture Science prosthetic multi-tools. Please charge them in the multi-tool charging station. Please locate the charging station and charge your multi-tools.
Where?
Do you want me to tell you?
No. What's this? We got timers and stuff. What's this?
Good. Now press the button on the multi-tool. Good. Your multi-tools have been fully irradiated. Please remove your radiation suit at this time.
Irradiated?
No suit detected. Good. There is a cabinet of drawers in your repair station. Please locate it and open a drawer.
Walk around the room, Stacy. You're just standing in one spot.
I know, but it's kind of fun to like.
Locate and open the correct drawer.
Okay.
Good. You have now practiced on two incorrect drawers. Please open the correct drawer. Good. As explained in your orientation, you should, of course, never look directly into the drawer. Room sensors indicate you are currently looking directly into the drawer. You have just interfered with an Aperture Science Pocket Universe test.
Stacy!
You are their god.
What?
Close the drawer to initiate contaminated pocket universe contingency protocol.
Oh my god! What have I done?
I've never seen anybody destroy the pocket universe! Those are people, Stacy!
Good. Contaminated pocket universe incinerated.
Oh my god!
Pocket universe has been removed from your list of responsibilities.
What is this?
Please look at the service bay door.
Why? Why do you do these things? Why do you kill everything, Stacy? Don't kill him! He's trying to survive! You horrible. Why do you kill everything?
Oh my god.
He can't be trusted.
No, that's true.
Now serving. One.
Whoa. You seem troubled.
As you can see from the schematic hologram, all Aperture brand robots can be repaired by anyone with even a rudimentary understanding of advanced electromechanical engineering. To begin repairing this unit, Attach your multi-tool to its faceplate and pull as forcefully as possible. You may hear what sounds to a human like mechanical screaming, but rest assured, while robots feel pain, they cannot express it.
What? That's horrible!
Locate and press.
You're the one who just destroyed a pocket universe and tried to smush the one trying to escape.
I forget what I was trying to do here. What am I trying to do?
Locate and press the button.
Press the button.
Good. Step 2. Locate half-inch bore number 35 pitch sprocket or amp flow motor D and disengage it from the appropriate linear actuator unless its electrostatic ion reactor is uncoupled from anodized multi-axis circuit bracket 733D and only if oxidization valves A, C, F, and H1, but not H3, are asymmetric to turbopump exhaust manifold.
Okay, Stacy, start doing
please
it!
Please take your time.
Yeah.
Up to 30 seconds, at which point the thermoreactor currently uncoupled from its heat exchange unit will detonate. Alert klaxon deploy.
It's gonna die. Yeah. Good.
Again, take your time. 15 seconds. 15 second klaxon deployed. Increased heart rate detected. Ocean sounds relaxation klaxon deployed.
Spring relaxation sounds, okay? I killed the robot.
Good. All responsibilities have been removed from your list of responsibilities. Or meltdown in supervisor has emerged.
I don't believe it. What kind of robot can't handle the simplest? Oh, it's you.
Oh god.
Congratulations on your quota-filling promotion, by the way.
Woo!
You've opened all our eyes to what humans can achieve when you put your tiny little
look
minds to
how
it.
How huge does he look? How huge
safety,
does he look?
Please vacate this station immediately.
How big does he look?
Him, you'll be fine.
How cool
also, let's
yeah.
be honest.
How big
the first
does he
day's
look?
Been a bit
huge.
Of a disaster. It's probably not the worst thing if you die.
So the interesting about this is, like, on the screen she doesn't look that big, but when you have the 3D glasses on, she looks like her head is the size of your body. Bigger.
Repair station
bigger.
Recycling in
yeah.
progress.
I want you to know, at first I was against this human diversity outreach program. But now, watching you flail around like a sweaty pile of ham, I see I was wrong. It's hilarious. Honestly, I think you're overqualified for robot repair. I've got a better assignment for you.
Repair station recycling, complete. Thank you for your participation.
That's a recording. He has to say that. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Oh dear. Oh, shit. That's cool. Well, I destroyed the pocket universe.
Never seen anyone just open it up and start smashing things.
I just wanted to see what happened.
You're the one who was mad that some guy was punching a jellyfish.
Well, that's different.
How is it different? Those were small sentient beings.
Expedition
I didn't realize they were sentient beings.
They were praying to you!
Yeah, you're gonna smack that dog now, aren't you?
No!
Is now primordial element extract.
Look at
his butt! Look at his little butt! Look at his little butt!
Butt around!
Meanwhile, we have two dogs in real life staring at Stacy, like, what?
They can tell what I'm doing, I bet. They're like, what are you doing? They're like, I can see that you're petting a dog. Clearly.
Fucking ghost dogs.
Clearly not me.
They're hard to get when they're walking sideways. Ah!
Oh! Nice!
Ah, he jumped!
Oh, smarty pants. Yes!
And you can also get those red balloons for more health. And these guys have helmets on, so you have to hit them like 5 times. Oh, no!
Yay!
Okay,
Okay, these guys will absorb your arrow, so you have to get them in the head. Aha! I got him! I'm getting really lucky right now, don't worry.
You've also been playing this a lot longer than I have.
I played this one time, Stacy.
I'm just saying, you already knew how to play.
Don't worry, Stacy. A lot of people have a hard time with this one. I was watching videos, a lot of people have a hard time. Just rapid fire all the time.
Along its surface.
It might be fun to listen to what the cores have to say.
Do not approach
it.
Instead, approach the calibration unit and begin calibrating cores.
Grab it and then pull it back. And then don't let go.
Oh, hey.
Whoa.
So excited. Are you the calibration guy?
So you want to explode
stuff. This is my first time. Pleased to meet you. What's your name?
Aim them at stuff. Go.
When does it start, by the way?
I mean, okay, then let go.
Oh my gosh, are we doing it already?
So those, see those red barrels? You want to hit those because those are explosive.
Am I up for a calibration?
Yeah.
I can't see anything, but
you're up, guy.
Kind of like something was going on with that last calibration. What, you know, what happened to the other guy?
Oh,
I
missed.
The name is Wilson.
Man.
I'm the boring, hard-boiled core. But in a minute, and I'll give you the lowdown on my latest caper. I've been...
Deal for you. Up for bid. What a one-of-a-kind museum quality item. A bag of garbage.
What's inside this bag of garbage?
Yes, garbage, but what?
Oh!
What? Trying to go for that one at the back.
This just feels right.
Ah!
Damn it. No, you got no more. Oh, that's it. Okay. Yeah, restart. touch.
Just go over there and touch it.
You are fired.
I'm fired?
Yeah.
Well,
just go over there and touch it.
Oh, okay. So basically just... Oh, so like, yeah.
You want to destroy everything.
Yes.
Whoop. Welcome, Core Calibration Trainee. When you're ready, approach the calibration unit and begin calibrating cores.
Calibrating, quote unquote. Man,
approach
there's like a
the
lot
calibration
of stuff here.
And begin calibrating cores.
All right.
Hey, hey, hi. So excited. Are you the calibration guy? Great.
Oh!
Am I up for a calibration?
Sweet.
I can't see anything, but, you know, sounded like something was going on with that last calibration. What, you know, what happened to the other guy? Is he... Oh!
I am the Reverse Psychology Corps. Don't worry, Reverse Psychology only works on stupid people. I can tell you're far too smart. Jack May!
This is tricky.
I am the Investigation Corps. I am here to investigate the ongoing damage to the storage annex, of which you are the primary suspect. And I gotta tell you, it does not look good for you. Guilty!
Oh, so close!
So close.
Hello, I am the Morning Corps. Please, sit down. I have troubling news. The Investigation Corps was killed in the performance of his duties earlier today.
Damn it!
Aww.
Oh well.
My turn!
There
your
are
turn.
No more cores coming. They do not trust you. You are.
Stacey's just like. She turned into like a mannequin. She's like, I'm ready to be unplugged.
Well, hold on. Just gotta get it. Oh, that's my face thing.
Too bad.
That's whatever.
I sprayed mine with disinfectant anyway.
you sprayed your face with disinfectant?
No, I was worried that you were gonna, like, you know...
Judge your face?
Judge my face, and also I just didn't want you to feel uncomfortable.
Yeah.
So I sprayed everything with disinfectant.
Well, I mean, you know, who knows how long we'll play it for.
Exactly. And also, like, you don't want to get, like, bacteria in that and get pimples. And...
Yeah. Whoa, hold on. Do you want some help?
I got it!
You sure?
I'm a bastard!
I'm all over this.
There's a lot of core tangling at the Mari house.
Welcome, Core Calibration Trainee. When you're ready, approach the calibration unit and begin calibrating cores.
I like when they're like, they do not trust you.
Hey, hi. So excited. Are you the calibration guy? Great. It's my...
Damn it.
Hey, am I up for calibration? I can't see anything, but, you know, sounded like something was going on with the...
Damn it!
This is the Emergency Preparedness Corps. Please calibrate to enable everyone.
It's Gas Tracer Corps.
Ladies and gentlemen on the airplane, welcome to the inaugural flight of the Aperture Science Corps-driven air travel initiative. This is your...
Oh, there goes one of the barrels.
Climate Change Awareness Corps. Please calibrate me so that I may cause climate change and raise awareness of the changes I am making to the climate.
I can't believe I just got, like, all the way there.
Okay, well,
I'm
like, oh, yeah, I'll just go over there.
The one sliver that's, like, not a thing.
Welcome, Core Calibration Trainee. When you're ready, approach the calibration unit and begin.
Oh, hey, I'm so excited. Are you the calibration guy? Oh, am I up for calibration?
Damn it!
Oh, so close.
I am the Climate Change Awareness Corps. Please keep the thought.
There we go.
Corps. I'm here to investigate the ongoing damage to the storage annex, of which you are the primary suspect. And I got a guilty!
Damn it!
Oh,
I'm not a gateway to the netherworld.
Not a gateway to the netherworld.
Calibrate me so I can be useful.
Damage threshold breached.
Hello, I am the Morning Core. Please, sit down. I have troubling news. The Investigation Corps was killed in the performance of his duties earlier today.
Boiled core. Button up a minute and I'll give you.
Ah!
Yes!
I am the fruit punch core. I am filled with refreshing fruit punch.
Fruit punch core.
My tropical flavors!
So you have to get a certain amount of damage in order to get more balls. I don't know what that was about.
Welcome, Core Calibration Trainee. When you're ready, approach the calibration unit and begin calibrating cores.
Begin core.
Okay, hey, sir.
Welcome to the inaugural flight of the Aperture Science.
Okay, Chief.
Oh, there
we tried calibrating things your way and it didn't get us squat.
Damn it.
I am the Executive Core. Please action calibration now.
Game changer!
I'm a loser. I suck. You know what the Pocket Universe reminded me of? That
test
of
traveler
at
Pocket Universe Lab 8 has successfully survived an experiment.
God, Morty, you can't just throw a card word and a space word together and have it mean something. Now let's check on the microverse battery. So it looks like I'm in like a... I don't know how to explain. Easier.